The Fitness Gram Pacer Test is a multi-stage aerobic capacity test that progressively gets more difficult as it continues.
So, idiocy, or first ever okay, no, actually, debunking furry arguments is idiocy, but more limited edition. Anyways, we're not limited anymore this time. Why? Because I've said so, and you guys said so too, so you know what? Let's start raping fucking arguments, mate!
Brief presentation on anti-furry nationalism by Gone Fishing. Anti-furryism, or anti-furry nationalism as we know it currently, was the brainchild of a dude named Joseph Skarnov. Just about 3 years ago in early 2021, Joseph is credited by multiple anti-furry pages as the creator of not only the first anti-furry account to use the flag, but the flag itself. This was from an article that I found saying anti-furry flag by Joseph Skarnov, and this is from an anti-furry website saying Joseph Skarnov is the founder of anti-furry action. Here's some more references to him. Here's another anti-furry that posts the flag from back in 2021 saying that it was created by anti-furry action, aka Joseph Skarnov. And also here is a ad on the previously mentioned anti-furry website saying that anti-furry action has the best anti-furry propaganda. Okay, but what's the big deal? Who cares? Okay, who cares who created a Gone Fishing? Unless you have, like, some crazy proof that, like, he was a neo-Nazi, I seriously doubt that that exists. That can't be real. Big shock, it actually is f***ing real. The anti-furry flag is based on the flag for the National Socialist Revolutionary Movement, a neo-Nazi group from Moscow. There is literally no debate that we have here. Skarnov is referenced across multiple anti-furry pages as its creator, and the flag itself is based off of a Russian neo-Nazi group's flag. End of story.
Wait a minute. So you're telling me that the anti-furry flag is based over a neo-Nazi flag? You know what? I'm gonna give you that one. Totally valid. However, you're forgetting the small point that the third Reich flag, the swastika in the middle, was stolen, not even based, it was literally stolen from the Hindu. So according to your theory, Nazis are Hindus. Or aren't they? Because, I mean, when you think about it, Nazis weren't even based over the Hindu swastika. They just took the shit and slammed that bad boy on their goddamn flag. Also, when you think about it, that a flag is similar to another flag means nothing. I mean, this argument is more, like, invalid than a fucking maps claiming that, you know, they're not a pedophile. Because when you think about it, the UWF, or whatever the name of this organization was, looks exactly like the fucking Nazi flag, but these guys don't fucking gas Jews. What they do is they found American farmers.
Wow.
All right, next one, gentlemen. Bring it on. We're not 5 seconds in, and I already want to kill myself. The music is annoying as fuck.
Have you ever been walking down the street?
Mind your own business. I saw a group of people dressed as fuzzy animals.
Fuzzy animals?
No, never happened to me, but if it ever happened to me, you could bet millions of dollars, legal authorities would be involved. Unless we live in Chicago, of course. Crime is legal there, apparently.
Were you confused? Wondering why in the world someone would do that? Maybe you've seen some art of anthropomorphic characters.
Oh, trust me, I did, and I regret it every fucking day in my goddamn miserable life.
And wondered what that was all about. Well, my friend, you've been exposed to furries. I'm Solar Saber, and today I'll be telling you exactly what a furry is.
Now, if you don't know what a furry is, allow me to explain. Furries are a mix of animals and humans, that's the main thing, but there's a lot more to it than this. You see, furry is a lifestyle, not just an interest. Your basic average furry is a man in his 30s, overweight, socially inept, and really dirty. Says he has Asperger, so he doesn't have to answer for the way he kills conversations faster than cancer.
Whether you're a confused parent or a curious viewer, I'll try to make it easy to understand. Let's start with the basic Google definition of a furry, which is an enthusiast for animal characters with human characteristics.
Today on the island of Sodor, we'll be figuring out who the fuck ass.
That's a lot of people, actually. I'm sure people who wouldn't label themselves as a furry find characters like those from The Lion King or Zootopia interesting.
What kind of interesting? What kind of interesting? I'd like to know what kind of interesting, cause
The way most of us animal enthusiasts show our enthusiasm is through art.
I don't think any of you want to look at the art. Which are just animals. Don't search it up. Don't search furry in Google and go to images.
Fursona, which is one of the first steps to joining the furry community.
Cap, you don't need a fursona. What you need is to like furries and label yourself as a furry. There you go, you're a furry, my friend. Now I'm gonna grab a shotgun and get rid of you.
A fursona is a representation of yourself, but in animal form. Fursonas have no boundaries. You can have one, or you can have three. It can be the same gender as you, or it can be the opposite.
The same, or the opposite? Meaning that there are only two? LGBTQ phobe confirmed.
Next, I'm going to talk about the thing furries are most known for.
Autism! Hold on, what the fuck is that? The CDC? Woo! Wait, what the fuck?
A concern I've heard a lot about furries is that we're just hiding behind a mask because of low self-esteem or something. For the most part, that is not true. Furries are simply playing a role because it's fun.
Do you have an idea how hot those things are? And I'm not saying hot like style, I'm saying like that's a fucking oven. Let's just say it's not as fun as it seems. Because it's hot inside there.
Think of an actor. Would you say that actor is running away from their problems by pretending to be different characters? No, you wouldn't. The same goes for fursuiters. They're just fuzzy actors. It's fun to make someone smile because they saw a person in a giant dog costume walking down the street.
So you like being a joke, right? Like instead of having a respectable life, you'd rather be a joke. They're laughing at you.
Back to another point I made in the beginning. Furries are just enthusiasts for animals with human characteristics. Contrary to popular belief, we do not think we are actual animals.
Then why the fuck you represent yourself as one? God damn!
The people who believe they are animals are Therians, not furries. You can look that one up if you want to. Let's get into the other big thing, furry conventions. Since most of the world thinks we're weird, which is fair, furries really only get to go all out at furry conventions. A furry convention is just a big gathering of people with a shared interest in anthropomorphic animals. This is where furries get to wear their fursuits, sell their art, socialize, and just have a good time. There are tons of furry conventions, but most are located in the United States. The biggest currently is Midwest Fur Fest in Illinois, followed by AnthroCon in Pennsylvania. If you're a parent of a furry convention is a great place to take your child.
No, don't do that, no.
Because most have panels such as Teen Meet and Greet, or Parent Discussions, where you can ask questions about what the furry fandom is.
Or you can just not take the risk and nothing happens.
Most furry conventions also have a fursuit dance competition, which is very entertaining to watch.
Most hilarious shit I've did it in my fucking life, I gotta say.
Okie dokie, next one, we're gonna watch this other hypocrite. Editor, put him on the screen.
Heyo everyone, Misha B. Barkin here.
Oy vey. Cringe.
Ah, Midwest Fur Fest. The furry community's biggest convention currently, especially after this year with the total attendance being a whopping 13,641 furries coming together for a weekend to enjoy and celebrate all the diverse and wonderful things in this community.
Oh my, that word, diversity. Oh my god, if you don't know what's wrong with that word, and liberals using it. Bro, you don't wanna know. You don't, if you don't know, you don't wanna know. And if you know, you wish you didn't. When they say diversity, they mean all the fucking opposite. They be, oh my god. When they say equality and diversity, you know it's gonna be bad. You know it's gonna be shit.
And of course, to fun now with much bigger conventions, it's going to attract some people who aren't in the community, but are mostly curious about furries and maybe want to learn more.
Dialogue? I can't see the end of the horizon. Hatsune Miku!
This time, however, was a bit different, with there being protesters. Yeah, you heard me right. Furry protesters coming together to fight the big fight against people dressing up for a hobby? Ulterior motive? Never heard of her.
You left-wing leaning parasite. You expect me to sit here and listen to your drivel?
I couldn't make it to MFF this year due to financial reasons.
Make some
But this was all over Twitter and has kind of been this week's joke within the community. So yeah, this year's MFF saw its own version of a supervillain, fitting the theme of this year's con, in the form of protesters.
I have no words. These guys are crying about two protesters. Wow, like, these guys really want, like, tell me you're a snowflake without telling me you're a snowflake. Wow. No words. No words. I really don't have any.
A whopping two of them. Let's get a closer look, shall we? This is not normal. Yeah, no shit. Furry stuff is weird, but who cares?
They care. They seem to care. Like, don't you see?
What's even weirder is expecting people to fit in a box of normality and to forfeit having any fun and meeting people with similar from strangers? Who the f*** cares what they think?
I love this one, right? Because furries suffer from harassment all the time, and they come whining to me and crying to me to stop slurring. They come and cry to me and tell me to stop bullying them. All of a sudden, they come up with this shit. And they'd be like, who cares what they think? If you really didn't care, you wouldn't be coming here and crying in my comment section. So I stopped bullying you online. But you do. Stop. I'm not playing that game. Alright? You're being like so contradictory all the time. Like, man. Who cares? Then you start crying like the little snowflake you are. You seem to care what those protesters actually think about, because if you didn't, you wouldn't be making this video. It's a saber wolf situation all over again.
This is what a dying society looks like. Oh no, a bunch of people having fun. The horror.
I mean, when you think about it, they kind of have a point though. You see, society cannot function without morals. Society cannot function without standards. The thing that furries lack the most, I can say, from own experience. I'm gonna reveal you a little secret though. When I was a furry, many of you know that I am a former furry. When I was a furry, I was a dick to my parents. That is until I joined the anti-furry movement. And oh boy, I don't regret anything about this movement. I stand by that statement.
I love how his sign is pointing at her and not the furries across the street, because to be honest, he's right. Hating random people you don't have similar interest with and wasting your Friday night to stand in the cold and yell slurs at furries is an unbelievably perfect example of a dying society. And yes, there's multiple people who can attest to being called slurs. Once you start expecting everyone around you to agree with and be in line with everyone you believe or like, you'll start building up walls with people for no good reason and thus killing society. Wait a minute. Hold on. And enhance. Oh, it all makes sense now. The slurs, the homophobia, the transphobia, hating people who aren't like him.
Furry, woke, liberal, detected. Yo. All right, hold on. Let me just show you how ignorant this guy is. Give me a moment. Ladies and gentlemen, I am glad to present to you Trump's homophobia out of damn control. Trump went so homophobic this time, to the point he decided to host a gay marriage, a gay wedding, in his own fucking penthouse. Would you fucking care? Well, according to this fucking fur fag, you know, this guy, yeah, the one that we're like viewing his bullshit now, claims that Trump is homophobic. Sure, buddy. Sure. This is the thing about liberals, right? They talk, they have no fucking idea, but they talk. They don't even try to like, you know, make it make sense, right? Because you're telling me that supporting Trump is something homophobic. The guy just hosted a fucking gay wedding in his, like, freaking hotel or some shit. Like, bro, get a grip on yourself. And why does your pa have 5 fingers? Yeah,
Got it. Honestly, still sporting Trump stuff in the year of our Lord and Savior 2022 is worse than wearing a giant dunce hat. Or having a bumper sticker on your lifted Dodge that says, I can't think for myself and only do what Daddy Trump tells me. You know, for a side spouting facts over feelings, they can't seem to accept election results from 2 goddamn years ago. Anyways, certified society moment aside, it's just hilarious to me how this is how they decided to spend their Friday night across the street from a convention where people came from all over to meet their friends, yelling hateful things out in the cold streets of Rosemont.
Absolutely based. I condemn.
Clinging to their little signs and pretending they're the good guys. It's just depressing, really. On a brighter note, though, Boozy Badger was nice enough to provide us with a wonderful meme template, so let's check out some of those in the replies, shall we?
You know what's funny, as I am admitting this? They make this type of jokes of, like, you know, feces and shit, and then we are the childish kids. Like, you're a grown-ass adult wearing animal costumes and making poopy jokes. Like, what? What? How does that make any sense? Like, you notice how hypocritical you are, right? This is the thing I said about liberals. I'd rather have a 4-year-old as a president before having a woke, a liberal, a vegan, a leftist idiot as a president. I'd rather put there a 4-year-old child, because at least the child won't trash America, right? At least he will, you know, maybe he will go to Disneyland every day, but at least the economy will stay the same. Liberals are designed to fuck up everything they touch, like, for real, and look how hypocritical they are. You're a child, you're 7-year-old, hey, at least I'm 7, at least I am the teenager acting like the adult, not the adult acting like the teenager here. A little respect, bitch. So here you have what it is, a random picture of a centurion shot cow, if I'm not wrong. So I was scattering through the internet to find more furry cap, searching my comments, couldn't find anything as well, so I decided to, well, grab some random shit and put it on here, because why not?
Did you miss me?
No, I missed Hitler more than you, not gonna lie.
What's that? I look different? I got a haircut.
Let's go with that.
If you could
tell by my animalness.
I'm a furry.
Furry stating fucking utterly retarded rapist yapper. No worries, fam, you can thank me later for explaining to you what it stands for.
And apparently, a lot of people don't like that. Some of which, ironically, even get to the point where furries are all they can think about, which is pretty funny. A great example of this would be our good pal Isaac Butterfield. Yes, that's his real name. And as you can see, he's taken quite a liking to furries as of recent. It's all he can fucking talk about. That, and his disliking for minority group.
I fucking hate snowflakes. He's already offended, if you can't tell.
He is self-proclaimed, by the way, Australia's most controversial comedian. I think the quotes are in the wrong place.
I've heard in my fucking life. Funniest shit I've heard in my fucking life, for real.
He sure as hell controversial. I don't know about a comedian.
Hey, faggot! This video is directed towards you, idiot!
You will never be a real woman. You have no womb. You have no ovaries. You have no eggs. You are a homosexual man twisted by drugs and surgery into a crude mockery of nature's perfection. All the validation you get is two-faced and half-hearted. Behind your back, people mock you. Your parents are disgusted and ashamed of you. Your friends laugh at your ghoulish appearance behind closed doors. Men are utterly repulsed by you. Thousands of years of evolution have allowed men to sniff out frauds with incredible efficiency. Even trannies who pass look uncanny and unnatural to a man. Your bone structure is a dead giveaway. And even if you manage to get a drunk guy home with you, he'll turn tail and bolt the second he gets a whiff of your diseased, infected axe wound. You will never be happy. You wrench out a fake smile every single morning and tell yourself it's going to be okay, but deep inside you feel the depression creeping up like a weed, ready to crush you under the unbearable weight. Eventually, it'll be too much to bear. You'll buy a rope, tie a noose, put it around your neck, and plunge into the cold abyss. Your parents will find you, heartbroken but relieved that they no longer have to live with the unbearable shame and disappointment. They'll bury you with a headstone marked with your birth name, and every passerby for the rest of eternity will know a man is buried there. Your body will decay and go back to the dust, and all that will remain of your legacy is a skeleton that is unmistakably male. This is your fate. This is what you chose. There is no turning back.
We'll find out. I'd like to start off with one of his shorts. Comedian reacts to outrageous furry TikToks.
Today we're gonna hang out with some furries.
I'm a fursuit maker and artist based in Sydney.
And did you make all
these ones?
The
lights are on.
Yeah,
but
they're all handmade.
Nobody's home.
How much are the suits that you make?
Around $3,000.
$3,000? Just go to a therapist.
To me?
Oh, yeah, the furries need the therapist, not the guy recording himself insulting them.
This mother f- what are you even- what? Your fursona, whatever this shit is, has a fucking open tank top or whatever that is, a fucking jacket. Bro! What the fuck?
Yeah, Isaac's locked in. He's not insecure at all.
Hold on, what is gaslighting, manipulating, such as gaslighting? What is gaslighting? That's an interesting one. Gaslighting is an in- what the fuck is- Gaslighting is an intrusion form of manipulation, psychology control. Victims of gaslighting are the very way. Oh! Fed false information! That leads them to question what they know to be true. Often about themselves. They might end up doubting their memory, perception, and even their sanity.
Maybe I do have PTSD.
My brain is functioning like a fucking Plentium dual core.
Why do I feel like I just smoked pound and a half of marijuana? My gosh, my brain is melting.
Oh!
This is a Malamute.
What's a Malamute?
Malamute. It's a species of sled dog.
Why are you one?
It's similar to an Alaskan Husky.
Why are you one?
Because it's fun to play pretend, Isaac. I mean, you're pretending to be a comedian.
What do you like about the furry community?
I love predominantly the self-expression, like the ability for people to express to such an intense degree.
What the fuck are you expressing? Except yourself in a litter box in a fucking public toilet. I feel we need to bring back a bit of judgment. People are too free.
Yeah, we've been judging something here the whole time, and it was not the furries.
Yeah, manipulators. No, you know what? I'm just gonna maybe cut it here.
Isaac here also, like, religiously believes in the school litter boxes thing, which has been proven to, like, not be true at all?
School district denies litter boxes for students identifying as furries. A concerned parent said they were really disturbed after hearing that litter boxes were being provided to students who identified as furries. If you allow kids to identify as theys and thems and everything in between and pick their own genders, this is what happens.
We are dealing with an absolute genius here, y'all.
Alright, mate, if we let Sam become Sally, they're gonna wanna shit in boxes.
I mean, he's no fucking wrong. Look at your father, he's nowhere to be seen.
I feel like I'm watching a Saturday Night Live skit. Like, this guy cannot be real.
This is my first time going to FurryCon, and I am jumping with joy because there's gonna be so many cute baka's there.
Isaac, no, you're getting baited. That video's not real. It doesn't take a genius.
If you don't know what a furry is basically someone who dresses up as an animal and they live that persona. Now, and I may have got that wrong, but frankly, who cares? Fuck the lot of you.
You're right, Isaac. Who cares? Who cares? I don't care. You care. You shouldn't.
What do you mean, shouldn't? We all should care about this because this is no human behavior. This is degeneracy at its peak.
I'm also super excited because there's gonna be so much free cat food and kitty treats.
See what I mean? This is getting slippery. It's slippery.
If you couldn't tell by the lack of frontal lobe development to realize that this is satire, Isaac is in fact a millennial. I think I'm gonna blame it all on that. Like, your age starts with a 3. I'm getting you a walker for your birthday. Fire!
Dear viewer, if you are watching this, if you're still here, let me tell you two things. One, you have a higher attention span than the average person these days. Congrats. Secondly, I'm sorry for you to needing to see the last part of that cringe-ass gaslighting fucking trance. And in reward, I want to show you a couple of things. Hold on, stay tuned.
We see all these people with mascot outfits on. We're like, what is going on? And we talked to this guy, and he said, there's a furry convention in town.
Oh, right.
And I said, wow, this is crazy. So they all decided to get together. So they were at bars and on the streets, and it was like a get-together. They used to do it in San Diego, but at the time, San Diego was a little bit more conservative, and they were having a hard time doing it, so they moved it to Pittsburgh. And this was the year they moved it to Pittsburgh. Mm. This is according to him. So we check into the hotel. The hotel, the guy who was working the front desk was saying how crazy it was that these folks were asking for their food to be delivered in bowls on the ground so they could eat it like animals. And I'm like, that is crazy. And then he said they asked for a litter box in the lobby. Now, they didn't put a litter box into the lobby, but someone, according to this man, asked him for a litter box. Mm. I'm like, that is crazy. So I went and did a deep dive online. I went to forums where furries go, because I was trying to find, like, is this a thing? Do they like to use litter boxes? Out of all of my searching, I could only find one poster, one guy who said he had used a litter box.
Mm.
So this one person who was saying that he thought it was kinky and he liked to use it, he, they, it, them, whatever, liked to use a litter box.
Mm.
So that was all I could find. So is that something that people do, or is it something that people talk about doing because it's fun? I don't know. But one of the things that I found about these furries is, like, it's sexual in some sort of weird way. They like to get together and have sex with their furry outfits on, and they don't want people to know who they are or what they want to keep the outfits on.
So it's a cosplay kind of thing.
Yeah, it's like a cosplay kink thing that some people engage in. Like, how that got connected to gender, I do not understand.
Thank you for watching, and I'm sorry if this video got very long, but there was a lot that I could address, with a lot of stuff. And hopefully this will not be the last idiocy, just like happened to suffer. I'll see you later, commanders. Hope you have a great day.